capturing the live signal of the Roberts playing directly on two tracks, and then the loops, the orchestral fills that you're hearing, are the previous live tracks that are continuing to play in the background. And what we're doing is setting up a bed, sort of a background texture, upon which we will find the 3, 4, or 5 note theme that is the window's sound. And so what we've been doing is something like this. Robert, can you go back to what we were just doing?
The very
guitar?
Basic form?
Yeah, the simple basic form, the human slide
the
form
human
as
form,
best
all right.
you can.
What you might do for that is take it to the top loop. It's a gentle human form rather than a strident form. You might have if we take out the background you almost.
And again.
And then if you move to something a little more muscular. We can change the backing around. So that the human character is playing over the top patch. And again. Steve has been directing me very efficiently and cruelly through all these various combinations.
And continuing in that theme,
yeah?
Let's say we start from scratch.
All right.
Blow this away. And this will be our last loop of the day.
All right.
And our job as audience and witnesses of this is to let go of all that we've just heard so that Robert can start from scratch as well. And Robert, why don't you build up a 5 to 7 minute loop? You find the theme, the texture, the context that goes back to what Jenny described earlier this morning, which is the idea that Vista embodies the Arrow principles. It's clear, confident, and connected.
And has green and blue.
And plenty of green and blue.
Cooler temperatures versus warm.
Green and blue.
And we will quietly make our way to...
Please walk around the room,
yeah.
Don't...
Better listening positions. Mm-hmm. John's been traveling with Robert for 16 years on and off?
Roughly, yeah.
Let's just say goodbye to this one. We'll go in just a moment. Thank you. different key. With some of this. Different key, it's a different word.
Okay. Alright. The echo, but the bells are going in the
right way. Alright, the bells are going in the right way. This note.
All the way up to the major third on the top. Starting on the third on the bottom. Starting on the sixth on the bottom. Starting on the sixth on the bottom rather than the third. Yeah.
There we go.
The echo on the or the tail?
Easily.
Lose the delay.
The delay.
So just the straight guitar. Favorite ending?
No.
And a little faster.
It gets That's me all working right. This boy.
All right. Not fair. All right, let's call that enough for now. If you fade that out, Robert, let's move over to Rick for just a quick second. This is Rick Seneschal, Microsoft Studios audio director. What's your title, Rick?
Audio manager.
Audio manager. Rick, can you pop back and give us a quick cross-section of what we've done for the past 6 hours? And Robert, take a break.
Thank you. This man gets me sweating. It's not fair.
So, Jenny, Rod, Todd, why don't you come a little closer? We've done probably 5 or 6 different types of things since this morning. We began with 3 or 4 quiet, subtle soundscapes designed to set a background texture upon which we can explore finding a 3 or 4 or 5 note melody. And we were all over the map in the first few hours, so generally there's this background bed that is created one note at a time, generally in a given key. And this is an exploration. So as Rick jumps between the various segments of what we did this morning, we'll eventually go back and look for the 2 to 6 seconds and the right 3, 4, or 5 notes and capture the essence of what we hope our startup experience will be for our visit.
And which are the...
Robert chose the key based upon, I think, initially color.
Two colors. You said green and blue.
Right.
I used my personal musical correlation with those colors to set up virtually all the themes we've been working on today.
Very cool. And we also built off of the presentation that you and Cheered and Don did this morning on the arrow themes, on the vista themes. So if you think even about this, clean, connected,
confident.
This is clean and connected, and I am less than confident about the vista themes, but we've been exploring explicitly themes that build on the visuals that are currently being developed for Vista.
So what key is blue and green?
It's combinations of D and E.
D and E.
D and E, how you can combine them in various ways. This is about the only exception where Steve said he wanted some darker timbres, so I moved to a slight brown.
And one of the things that we also have explicitly built into this process is the idea of building on the Brian Eno Windows 95 theme, which is fairly well known for people who've been running Windows 95 for 10 years and who are about to be blown away by Vista, and hopefully their old OS will also be blown away. But given Robert's history of working with Eno, we thought it would be interesting to use the Windows 95 Eno theme as a starting point. So there's a whole segment that is at least inspired by, if not related to, the Windows 95 theme. And this theme that you're listening to now is actually directly related to the Windows XP theme. So we began with the Windows XP startup sound melody, and Robert built a loop underneath it, and then began searching for this, what is a 7-note melody for the XP theme, explorations around an expansion and reorchestration of the XP theme. Here's a 4-note theme also that, based upon our early studies of what the Vista sounds evoke in people, is an ascending, hopeful, positive, uplifting, fairly analog human guitar sound that may or may not live on top of one of these thematic beds. In fact, one of the qualities we are after is we want to capture something that is timeless. We want to present something that feels and sounds timeless while remaining or retaining a human quality.
It
fact, Bill Flora just joined us. Bill is the creative director for Windows Media Center user experience team. Is that correct?
That's right.
Bill, this is Robert.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Bill has been a supporter of the idea of using your splashes for
Thank
the past
you. Mm-hmm.
couple of months.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Looking forward to hearing some more.
Well, there's several hours of it in here.
Which we'll look forward to hearing for the next few weeks.
And your color coding is in this as well.
Now, I mean, are we actually going to be able to hear the guitar? I mean, I started just using this for, how are you going to, what is it going to really sound like? That's my question.
We don't know yet. Okay. It's unfolding even as we speak.
Excellent.
In fact, part of the reason you were invited here today, and I'm sorry Robert couldn't make it, but we wanted to open the door, a little crack into the process of what it takes to capture a sound that will hopefully greet people as they feel good about starting their Vista machines. And it's a non-trivial process and problem to solve. So, maybe jump ahead a little bit also, Rick? Yeah, there were a couple of things, but there was one point in particular where I said, remember that. Do you remember where that was?
I played it already.
Oh, we went through it. Let's go all the way back to the end where we just completed and maybe wrap up here.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll move back into the conference room and complete this process for today. Hard work to do over the next month or so to take 3 hours, maybe 4 hours,
yes,
of raw material, find the essence, and slim it down to somewhere between 2 and 6 seconds. And for that process, I'll be relying on help from, in the end, Robert and John, as well as Brian Ledford from the EOM team, who's also a musician, Bill Flora, creative director, Rod, Jenny, and the entire MSX design team. If you know anything about what it's like to listen to 4 hours of soundscapes, which Robert does fairly regularly, and John does also almost for a living, it's going to be a trick and a tough job, but it'll be interesting to see, for all of us, in a month or two, what we come up with for this 4 second sound. So stay tuned and we'll talk to you again soon.
Fantastic.
Please turn that camera off immediately.